Assalamu alaikum. Okay guys, I know everyone love Palestine. Like I and my brother did. Please just listen carefully, the truth that my brother want to tell.
Remember back in October when people were telling us that, oh, Israel would never bomb a hospital, the IDF is the most moral army in the world. Well, I guess they have nothing to say now because these pictures of Al-Shifa Hospital were just taken the other day. And this is what it looked like before. And by the way, Al-Shifa Hospital was built in 1946, making it older than the state of Israel itself. And it's not just that they destroyed the hospital, but over 400 bodies of hospital workers, men, women, and children, were found to have been mutilated and executed at point blank. People, human beings, were found with zip ties on their arms and legs and appear to have been run over by a heavy vehicle such as a bulldozer or a tank. And it doesn't just stop there. Many of them also appear to have been purposely dismembered and burnt to a crisp. The pictures that came out and the pictures that I saw were absolutely horrific, and there's nothing that could possibly describe this level of barbarity. I didn't even think that human beings were capable of such actions, but I guess those who did this aren't human beings at all. They're demons. There's no other way to describe them.
For those of you who are visual learners, this is what's been happening the past 135 days of this genocide. Check this out. Remember when they told everybody move down south? It's going to be safer in the south. This is what you call indiscriminately bombing. Watch. Innocent men, women, and children all down there. They keep moving south, keep telling them to move south. Now they're here. The southernmost tip, where are they supposed to go? Where are they supposed to go?
Every time I try to say I'm here, but I have to say it in Arabic because they didn't understand my English.
Why you didn't travel like outside here? Why?
Because if I were to go outside, I would be like a monophic. I really believe that
Oh my God.
All Muslims need to be treated equally.
as an American, living in Gaza, I feel that all the Arabs in the world should be here helping, not just me. I feel like I'm the only foreigner in Gaza right now, and I would never leave, because if Israel's going to take all of Gaza or all of Palestine, that they want everyone to leave. That's why I stayed, because I don't want them to take Palestine.
Not survive this war in the Middle East. They may win the war, but they can't survive. Here's why I'm saying this. For them to win, they have to be so brutal, so savage, that the whole world will see them killing millions of people, including children. The world will turn against them. They carry out their agenda, they will be hated around the world. They know it. The West, which is primarily the United States and Israel, are in this war, and they have to win. It's not about Gaza. It's not about Hamas. It's now about the domination of Zionism. And if they lose, America becomes a third world nation, and Zionism is put out of business. If they win, all of humanity will become Palestinians, and the world will become a refugee camp. It's all or nothing.
What you see in this picture is a child who his school was destroyed, his house was bombed and destroyed, all of his teachers is dead and killed, all of his family is dead and killed, or separated from them, and he haven't eaten for the past month and a half, any bread or anything like that. He's been surviving on animal food and trees and leftovers on the road. He had to walk almost 50 kilometers to get to the beachside where the tanks and the Israeli soldiers was camping, and he found leftover bread from them and took it and ate it. That's a child you see who his whole future got messed up, and now the only thing is occupying his mind is how I'm gonna survive for the next hour. They offered him, the people recording this video told him, would you sell the bread? How much would you sell the bread you have in your hand? He said, I would not sell it for the world's money. And nowadays, we're being picky about this. I don't like this kind of bread. I don't like this kind. This guy has a weed on it. I am on diet. Kids in Gaza right now are starving to death. Literally, to death.